Today I'm going to show you a little bit about our brand new Shocker Flashbang holster and how to adjust it, how to get the most out of it. Now here I have it configured with the Akatsu Thunderbee Flashbang style. And when you get this in the mail, you're going to have all this extra cord sticking off of it. And a lot of people are going to be like, well, what the heck, you didn't even trim up the cord. Now we're going to leave this on there for a reason, just so it's easy to untie and tie the knots. To once you get it set to where you like, you can take this and you can trim it. Take a nice sharp pair of scissors, nice sharp knife, cut it, and then take a lighter or something hot and then melt the outside just a little bit, just enough to keep it from fraying. But that's why we leave it like this. And also, if you want, you can tuck it down in the front or tuck it in behind in the malice clip or in your webbing, whatever you want to do with it. But when you get it, we're going to leave it just like this. We're also going to include enough cord, shock cord, to where you can put it in this configuration, which is the bottom. This way, when you get it, it uses two pieces of shock cord, and then we send a single piece that is long enough to weave it like this, to where it goes across both on the bottom and the top, and then it has the one piece that goes across the bottom, just in case you're worried about losing it if you want to run your retention real loose. Now these will fit the Akatsu Flashbang style, they'll fit the ring style, they will fit the barbell style, they'll fit the dimple style, and they'll also fit the tornado grenade. But if you're going to use this style, I highly recommend just buying our original holster for the barbell style flashbang. This thing holds it really well. It's got a smaller footprint, and it's just better for these barbell styles. This will work, but our original one is better. For the ring style, I recommend that you use the single piece that has the bottom on it. That way, I have this one adjusted really tight. That way, the rings don't get caught up when you're pulling out, because they kind of get hung up on the kydex as you're pulling it out. So it's a little bit of a pain. So if you're going to use the ring style, I definitely recommend changing to the configuration with the bottom cord. And you can play around with it. You can get that as loose as you want, tight as you want. You know, there's a lot of adjustability built into this, which is why we went with this design and with the shock cord. Now, with that said, this is 100% made in the USA. The shock cord is 3/16 diameter mil-spec cord that's made in the USA. The malice clip is a tactical tailor malice clip, also made in the USA, as well as these screws. We use steel black oxide screws to hold it together. We use 80 thousandths thick kydex, and it's all 100% made in the USA, right down to the boxes we use and the shipping labels we use and the paper we use to print the invoice. It's all 100% USA. Now, the good thing about these is, one, you can run the spoon underneath the cord if you want. It's not going to prevent accidental detonation, but it just kind of keeps it out of the way. The spoon will also go in the back, no problem. You can see I've got this fairly loose, and the retention on it is, you know, it's not coming out even that loose. You can put it as tight as you want. You can also put the spoon in the back. You can put it in the front. You can put it wherever you want. Now, the main purpose of this video is the adjustment. It's really easy to adjust. These knots here, you can untie them. You might have to get something to grab a hold of one side. I don't recommend using your teeth, but, you know, you can do it that way. But basically, you can see right here how it's adjusted. It's got that little gap naturally. To adjust it, simply all you have to do is pull it out a little bit, get the knot, and you just grab the knot and you just kind of start rolling it back. You just roll it over itself, pull this one, and just roll it back down on itself, and it'll start to close up. That's the cool thing about shock cord. Even though you can roll the knot, once it's in place, it doesn't start to come undone. Now you can see there the gap starting to get smaller, and you do it on the top and bottom. You just keep rolling that sucker back, and you can feel it once you pull it. You can feel it'll roll one time, it'll roll twice, and that's the way you adjust it. The tighter the knot, the harder it is to roll. But now you can see, now I've got a smaller gap in there. And the same when you want to loosen it, again, you just grab the knot, and the knot will just roll forward. So very easy to change it. And then, of course, untie it if you want to completely take it out. But once it's in this configuration and you pull on it, it's not going to loosen up. Like I said, that's the Gloria shock cord. Now it starts to stretch on here rather than move the knot. So, but that's how you adjust it to get the perfect retention for any of your Thunderbee, Hakatsu Thunderbee products, tornado grenades, whatever you want to put in here. And then, like I said, if you get it really tight, if you set the retention very tight or use the bottom configuration, it'll even hold on to the spoon if you set it all the way clamp shut. It'll kind of hang on to this. Or if you got a pin, you can get the spoon to wrap around the shock cord a little bit. And that way, at least, you know, you'll have it on you. Most people have a dump pouch. So you're going to pick it up and just throw it in your dump pouch. But if you have this tight, it will indeed hold on to the core of the Thunderbee. So that's it. Brand new. The Shocker from VisionTactical.com. Check it out. Only $20 shipped anywhere in the world. I mean, $20 shipped in the U.S. And then anywhere in the world, we add $8.50 postage for shipping. So $20, can't beat it, free shipping, or $28.50 worldwide.